Get ready to match the stars. Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Rona Barrett, Richard Dawson, thank you, and Betty White. Oh, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rivers.
Johnny Olsen, hello there.
Hello, dear friends. Johnny, how are you?
Great, Gene.
We missed you.
Oh, we missed
you. Didn't we miss old John?
Yes.
That's right.
And we missed you. Haven't seen you in a while. Haven't seen you in ages.
Why do they keep us apart?
I don't know. Listen, I only do this for the people who are on a show for the first time, but you've been here, you've been gone so long. There you go. Shall we say hello to our two players here? Linda Abel and Rosalie Turner. How do you feel? Good. This little lady has a bundle of cash, $2,850 to be specific. She's being challenged by Rosalie, who's had both of her questions, right?
Right.
And you've matched five of our celebrities. And now you have one question left.
Right.
And you've got to match five to tie, six to win. It's easy for you. It's difficult for me. We'll see how this turns out in a moment or so, but right now we want to see about this. Jim, how are you, Jim? Good. Splendid. All right, here we go. This is all of yours, Linda. And everybody will play because she didn't match anybody in the first round.
Thrilled.
It says this. Everyone in the gym watched Judy limber up. Because instead of touching her toes with her fingers, Judy touched her toes with her blanks.
Oh, you're not a nice man.
All right, here we go. All together now. All right, put it right in the slot there. That means the lower tier is ready. Do not tarry, upper tier.
I'm finished.
Yes. All right, as soon as Charles is ready, we'll walk over here to Linda Abel and see what she has to say. Linda, what do you have to say to this? Everyone in the gym watched Judy limber up because instead of touching her toes with her fingers, Judy touched her toes with her blanks.
Breasts.
No, stick around. I know you're pregnant and all that. You're going to have a baby in a couple of months. But around here, we do the euphemism.
Oh, boobs.
Yeah.
I can put up with this.
You don't
have to. I know Betty's not
self-conscious.
Hello
there, Clifton.
Hello,
it's up to you. You're first.
Okay.
Judy touched her toes with her boobs, she says. What do you say?
Well, I think that's exactly what Judy touched her toes with, her boobies.
Her boobies, okay.
Arguments from the from those folks over
the
there
judges,
near
yeah.
the buzzer, because this is definitely a euphemism. Your fanny flags.
Your fanny flags. Yeah. Okay.
So far. Your Betty Whites.
Oh, your Betty Whites. Right. Now, Charles.
Yes.
So
I
far,
saved
we have
ink. Bull.
Now, Rona, honey. So far, we've got an even half dozen. What do you say?
How'd you like to go for eight?
All right. Why not? We go for eight? That
like,
means?
Except I don't think you could use those words boobs, so I said knobs.
Knobs. I tell you, it's an education in the
euphemism
dictionary of the American language to be on this program. Richard?
Whenever I'm watching television and I have trouble with my horizontal hole, I shall think of you.
Yes.
Let's say we've got five, we have four.
It's
so
five
far.
To four at this moment, and if you match Linda, that means you have a tie score. Then if she matches Betty, that means Linda will win another game.
Well, then you still have a chance, I don't.
Oh,
hi there.
Okay. Betty, honey, it's up to you.
It's
tie or a win?
I'm new here. I don't think as kinky as these other folk. I'm sorry. You see, it's a rather dignified thing. It wasn't all that much to watch. The only thing that made it more difficult was she was standing up at the time.
Oh, yeah. Rosalie, it was a pleasure meeting you, my dear. We've got some gifts for you, together with our thanks for being here.
Okay, thank you.
Goodbye, Rosalie Turner. Isn't she a sweet lady?
She sure is.
How do you feel?
Shaky.
Feel a little shaky?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll put my arm around you as we begin the Big Money Super Match here, where you can win over $5,000, as you know, because you've been here before. Linda, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Between the... I can't see around the corner. Between the blank. Okay, now the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 for the middle one, and $100 for the bottom one there. Whom do you call on for a little help?
Clifton.
Oh, I have two answers right quick.
Give us your
best shot. Between the lines.
Between the lines is one. Okay, Clifton?
Brett?
What do you say?
I have two. Let me see.
You got one, Brett?
Yeah. Oh, yes, I have two.
Let me announce it for you. This is her own game show, which unfortunately is not ever going to get on the air, and it's called...
Between the Sheets.
See what I mean?
Okay. Well, I hardly think you could go 13 weeks with that, then.
You'd be surprised.
Maybe it'll be a summer
series. My lucky man, Richard.
Okay, Richard.
Actually, the people are going to star between the devil and the deep blue sea.
Between the devil and the deep blue sea is one between the sheets and between the lines are the three, Linda. Do any of those sound good to you?
Yes, I thought of between the lines.
Okay, that's the one she wants. And she's got it. That's the one Clifton gave. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Between the eyes is not a bad idea, is it? Okay, we are looking for between the lines. May we see the $250 response? Devil in the Deep Blue Sea, the one that Richard gave you. All right, last chance for between the lines. Here's the $500 response. Lines it is! Okay. Congratulations, Linda. Now, Linda. You're up to $3,450 because you just picked up another $500 bill there. But more important, you're going to play for 10 times the $500 or $5,000. To collect, you have to match one of them head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Clifton.
Oh.
You ready, Clifton?
Well, ready, right up there? I hope so.
Linda will face me. And here it is, and it's worth $5,000. Left blank. L-E-F-T blank. Left blank. All right, he's finished. Now, Linda, your answer, which you think will match his, for $5,000. What do you say? Left blank.
Left hook.
Left hook?
Is that what he'd do in fighting?
Yes.
Is that a left hook?
Stay out of boxing. You'll never do it that way. I hope you do well here. We're going to find out right now if left hook matches him for $5,000. May we see it?
I'm left-handed. There's all so many good answers to this. I said left face.
Left face, yes.
I'm sorry.
Okay. There's left out and left leftovers out. And left all kinds
hard.
Of things.
That was a hard
left
one.
Left field.
Yeah, left field is another good one.
Left hand.
Okay, Linda, the $3,450 is yours, and you're going to play another game in a moment or so, but right now we've got a little message for America. This is it. All right, here we go. We're ready to play another game, and to do that, we have to have another player. So naturally, we're very pleased to present Mr. Rick Neely. You two know each other? Yeah. Fine. Nice to have you with us. Please tell us a little bit about yourself.
All right, I'm a freelance artist, among other things, and I'm currently working on a new series. It's entitled Theater Art. It's a combination of painting, sculpture, and drama.
Uh-huh.
Right, and I'm here visiting friends in Hollywood and playing in traffic, and glad to be here today.
Where are you based? Where is your hometown?
I'm originally from Kansas City, Missouri.
Yeah, and is that where your studio is?
No. I'm doing a lot of traveling.
Oh, right I now. See. All right. Good luck to Rick Neely. Let's begin, shall we? I'll push a button and ask you to make a selection here, Rick.
B, please.
B it is. Let's go. New game. At the sideshow, Tiny Tom Thumb decided to end it all. So he climbed inside the fat lady's blank. Yeah. Tiny Tom Thumb decided to end it all, so he climbed inside the fat lady's blank. I have a funny picture in my head at this moment.
I do too, and I just wrote it down.
Listen, while they're writing, may I point out to you that you may not see us on the tube here tomorrow.
Why?
Because we're going to be preempted.
Why?
Does that hurt?
Well,
I hate anything that hurts.
In this case, the person who's preempting us has promised to give the viewers back to us once she's used them.
Why, who's going to do it?
Rona Barrett has got a special tomorrow. And what the heck's it called again? It's called...
It's called Rona Looks at James Caan, Michael Caine, Elliot Gould, and Burt Reynolds.
Be still, my fluttering heart.
Oh, those old has-beens.
Yes.
I guess she couldn't get you and me.
No, she couldn't get us.
Rona,
are you ready over there? Okay, Rick, this is it. At the sideshow, Tiny Tom Thumb decided to end it all, so he climbed inside the fat lady's blank.
Girdle.
Girdle.
That'll definitely
you
do
squashed.
It.
Mm-hmm. Squashed. What'd you say, Clifton?
Well, having had little things crawling around in my past, I didn't want to put anything in my clothes, on my body, in the belly button.
Oh, very interesting. He was a lot smaller than I thought he was. What'd you say?
He was only about that big.
Oh.
And he wanted to be toasty warm when he passed over to the other side, so he crawled right in the little belly button.
There he is. That's two of those. Charles, what do you offer?
I'm afraid I said the same thing.
All right, three of those. No, no girdles, Rick, so far. Let's see if we have a girdle down here. What about you, Rona?
Well, I haven't worn a girdle in ages, but I wanted to keep it really clean, so I put it in a purse.
In a purse, yeah. He was asphyxiated. Too bad. Tiny Tom Thumb, at the sideshow, decided to end it all, so he climbed inside the fat lady's blank, and Rick said girdle.
Well, if you really want to end it all...
Yes.
You climb into her bra.
Into her bra.
Bra.
What does that do
like
to you?
Like the Grand Canyon caving in on
I see. Okay, I get
it's
the
It's a horrible
picture.
Way to go.
Oh, yeah, no, I wouldn't say it's a horrible way to go.
Well, I would.
I'd rather like it, as a matter of fact. How about you, Miss Betty, honey?
I just don't understand, because the girdle or the bra, he was so tiny, he would rattle around there for days and days and belly button my ear.
Yeah. So we had an ear and all kinds of things there. None for Rick, and now let's see how Linda does with her first round question, which is as follows. Dr. Bilbo the surgeon used to be a butcher. After he operates on you, he takes you off the table and puts you on a blank. Dr. Bilbo the surgeon used to be a butcher. After he operates on you, he takes you off the table and puts you on a blank. On a blank, because he used to be a butcher.
Well, I understand. There's no need to get cranky, you know.
Go, go, go.
Gee whizzakers.
Come on now,
I came
Charles.
Here to be refreshed, not insulted.
Did it already.
You did it already. Oh, that's right.
I'm doing my Christmas card.
All right. All right, Clifton.
Let's see. I can't. Oh, well.
Okay.
Wait a minute, I had to change my answer.
No, you're not allowed to change
it. Well, I've already changed it. It's in the slot.
Okay,
right,
Linda.
Dear?
Dr. Bilbo the surgeon used to be a butcher. After he operates on you, he takes you off the table, puts you on a...
Scale.
Scale. Okay. I've got about three answers in my head now. What do you say?
I don't know. That's a very logical answer, but seeing as I didn't eat a lot today...
Yeah?
After Dr. Bilbo took it off, he put it on the grill.
On the
grill.
He was gonna... Medium
well, listen,
or well
any
done.
Butcher worth his salt will eat his own meat.
Now,
huh? Come on. All right. Now, let's press on here to bigger and better things. Okay. I said he put it on the scale.
On the scale. That's one for Linda. Charles.
On the scale.
That's two for Linda. Dr. Bilbo used to be a butcher. After he operates on you, takes you off the table, puts you on a scale, according to Linda. What do you say there?
Well, since I'm an expert in meaty things...
Yes.
I always put them on a hook.
Put them on a hook.
Is that a good one?
Oh, I think it's a splendid answer.
You know, to age the meat.
Right, indeed.
Eat it a lot better. It's a lot softer, kinder to your mouth, to
That's
your tongue,
right,
to your
indeed.
Teeth.
That's enough. All right, Richard.
What happens then?
Well, that's the story.
At the end?
Yeah, that's
it. Was
the
very nice.
Yeah, it was interesting.
I like stories like that. Now, I know you're playing for two, Linda, aren't you?
Yes.
Little devil. And I know you left me the last time for that handsome devil who gave you grill.
Can't win them all, bitch.
But I know, but one you've got to come up with. El Scalo.
Scalo. I can't bear it.
That's a rerun. I weighed my answer very carefully.
Scalo. Scalo. Round one, four for you, none for you. And we'll go to round two in a moment or so, but right now this. Pay attention. Here we go. Round two coming up. There it is. Now, Rick.
A, please.
A it is. Everybody plays since no one matched him in the first round. Ralph is so repulsive.
How repulsive is Ralph?
I'll tell you. When he walks through the park, the blanks won't go near him. Ralph is so repulsive, when he walks through the park, the blanks won't go near him. When he walks through the park, really? Okay. Anything you say, dear. Ready, ready. Okay, ready, ready there. Okay. Here we go. Rick Neely. Ralph is so repulsive.
How repulsive is he?
I'll tell you, Rick. When he walks through the park, the blanks won't go near him.
I'll say muggers.
The muggers. That's right. He came up with a good one there. Should be a winner for him.
Yeah, well, it probably will
Maybe
be.
Maybe not with you, but not for
maybe
average
not
person.
With, I tell you, when you're really that repulsive.
Yeah.
That really, I mean, the past the muggers.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to go beyond human.
Oh.
The pigeons don't go near him.
Repulsive. Okay, Brad.
Isn't Rick a snappy dresser?
Yes, he is. Yes, he indeed
he
is.
He and Charles could pass for twins in their taste in clothes.
Right.
Look, that's a flower bag he has on his little body. I said muggers.
Muggers. Mr. Sartorial?
I haven't heard anything next to me in about a year and a half. Muggers.
Muggers. They do like each other. It's a little game they play.
Obviously, yes. They're crazy about one another. Such a new twosome in Hollywood.
Now, we're up to you. Ralph is so repulsive, when he walks through the park, the blanks won't go near him, and Rick said muggers.
Well, somehow I believe with the darling Clifton, but I don't go for pigeons. I went for the snakes.
Snakes. There are snakes in the park.
Yes, there are snakes that run around on the ground.
Two remaining ones to stay in the game here. Now, let's see what Richard has.
I have three clubs and a jack of spades.
No.
I shall raise you $2.
What do you have on your card, sir?
A little soup.
Writing.
Writing. Now, we would like to know what the writing spells out.
A word.
A word. Now, we are looking for a certain word here.
What's the word?
The word is muggers.
Congratulations.
Okay, Rick.
Little suspense, never hurt anybody.
Right. Now, Miss Betty, honey.
Oh, Mr. Raymond, honey, I just love being in this sixth seat. It means that you're really a stunk. If you let him down, now he's out of the game. He goes back to Kansas City. The office up over the candy store. Muggers.
Muggers! So at this moment, in round two, it's 4-4. When we come back from this commercial message, you're going to have to match one celebrity to win the game, all right? Now, we'll see you in a moment or so, but right now we want to do a little business with you. Now, would you say goodbye to whomever you want to say goodbye? You? Say goodbye to anyone?
Goodbye.
All right, that's nice. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye. See you next time. Listen, it's all been splendid. Say goodbye. to look in the camera,
where's
too,
the camera,
there.
Where's the camera, dear?
Bye. That camera over there. Just say goodbye.
Hi. I bye.
Say bye.
Bye. I'll see you.
We'll come back.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
See you, Rayburn.
Bonjour.
Bye. 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 Bye.